Okay, can an 8x8 thermal sensor be any good? Or at least, is it useful? And the answer is it can be if you can live within its limitations. Now, 8x8 is definitely not a high-resolution thermal imager, but it does have its place, and this is a 8x8 thermal imager I got from Banggood.com. $55. Very, very inexpensive. So let's plug it in and I'll explain. Okay, it boots up fairly quickly, and as you can see, it definitely gives us a thermal imaging. All right, so in this video, I'm going to show you the limitations as well as practical uses for this $55 thermal imager. Okay, so while checking the heating vent, here it is, I noticed that, of course, we expected a hot spot of the heating vent. What I didn't expect was to see two very warm areas sitting on the ceiling. So if I step back a little bit, you can see the heating vent followed by two lobes. Turns out that when the painters installed the heating vent back on the wall, they had turned it upside down by accident, thereby blowing the warmer air up to the ceiling. And even though this is an 8x8 pixel array, there's enough resolution to show what happened here. Okay, so I got up in a chair and I turned the vent upside down. As you can see, there are no hot spots on the ceiling anymore. I said, "That's done." But interestingly enough, it never occurred to me that it would blow it on the wall. And indeed, the heater is running right now. We got a little hot spot on the wall. Not that big a deal, but there it is. Oh, I suppose there's another hot spot. Kind of hard to see. There's a warm spot on my dresser, but I can't really show it to you right now. It's not showing up very well. So even in a low resolution of 8x8, there's still a lot of interesting things you can spot. Okay, so here is a 220 ohm resistor with just a 20th of a watt, but I'm several inches away. Now I'm going to go in very, very, very close. I'm probably in the order of half inch, which I guess would be about 12, 13 millimeters. You just get the faintest indication of it there. If I increase the current, let's go to 10th of a watt. Okay, now we're running a 10th of a watt. Again, from a distance, it's just a sea of noise. You have no idea where it is. Again, we're going to move in that, half inch mark. This is where you can start to kind of make it out a lot better. You can actually see the resistor and the heat it's producing, which is not very much, 25 point, it jumps, whereas the background is 20. So it shows up, but as I back off, we're, I don't know, 25 millimeters away, and it's just lost, 1 inch, by the way. Okay, so we're going to go to now a quarter of a watt. Okay, 30, crud, it's very hard to get this exact. And the harder I try to get it, oh, close enough. Okay, so here we are at a quarter of a watt from a distance of, several inches away. So I move in closer. I'm about a 1 inch away. Again, the heat from the resistor really starts to show up. You can get it fairly close. It's a bit on the fuzzy side, but you can do it. All right, so let's increase it to the half watt. 40. Okay, close enough. Okay, now, again, several inches away, you really can't tell much. Well, it's starting to show. Okay, I'm going to move to about 50 millimeters, 2 inches away. can kind of see as I move the camera across how it tends to jump. You can see it now. I'm like 50 millimeters away, or 2 inches. As I get very, very close to it, you can kind of make out the shape of the resistor, not very well. So it is able to detect, surprisingly, even a resistor. Let's see if we can get a good reading. Okay, so it's able to pick up the warmth of the resistor, and as I back off, you can kind of see it. Oh man, I'm like about 100 millimeters, which is 4 inches away, and you can kind of see that hot spot there. Blurry, but still there. You can kind of see it, but of course moving in closer gives the shape and detail of the resistor. Let's turn a little. I had it sort of a diagonal. Okay, I'm looking at a small candle flame, one of the little tea lights, from a distance. And let me move in a closer. About an inch away, you can kind of, you can't really see the shape of the flame as per se. But you can definitely see the heat signature from it. And again, if I back off, it's hot enough. And you notice how it sort of jumps across as I move the camera up and down. This is because we only have an 8x8 pixel. Now just for fun, okay, I just blew out the candle flame, but the residual heat you can still see is there. And we can actually get in closer now. And kind of measure it as it's cooling off.